Norway. No way. I mean Norway. They're in Norway.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
They call West Virginia the wild and wonderful state. And here in the heart of the Appalachian Mountains, the state capital, Charleston, is getting ready to play host to the World's Strongest Man finals of 2008. Now, also boasting a rather impressive mountainous backdrop is the host for our next qualifying contest, Norway. At over 1,000 metres, Stordfeld plays host to the third Super Series contest. And as before, the top four qualifying athletes all make it through to the finals to be held here in West Virginia later on in the year. So it's not just the altitude, but the stakes that are high. Let's take a look at the competitors. Sweden's number two, Kalle Lane. Also from Sweden, the 22-year-old Johannes Orsa. Norway's strongest man, Harald Haugen. Second of Britain's strongest man, Mark Felix. The world's strongest man of 2000, Jani Virtanen of Finland. And former Europe's strongest man, Poland's Jarek Dimek. Denmark's strongest man, René Minkwitz. And the 23-year-old from Boston, Massachusetts, Kevin Nee. He's nearly 60 years of age, Ode Haugen from Norway. And the world's strongest man of 1998, Magnus Samuelsson. The giant 6'5", 26 stone Richard Skog of Norway. And finally, second at world's strongest man last year, Sebastian Venter of Poland. These 12 men will battle it out over six disciplines in the mountain resort of Storefjell. Over to Colin Bryce then to explain the first event.
So anticipation is building as we're about to start, and event number one is the super yoke. 410 kilograms, that's 900 pounds, has to be lifted and then run down a 20 meter course, that's 66 feet. A very difficult start.
And it was too difficult for Denmark's René Minkwitz. He didn't manage a meter. Wasn't too much better for Sweden's Kalle Lane either. 11.33 for Kalle. And a disaster for Magnus Samuelsson. Richard Skog, well, maybe it was being at home that helped him complete the course. And now a battle for the ages. Ode Haugen, who qualifies for his bus pass rather soon, up against the 22-year-old Johannes Orka from Sweden. Will it be youth or will it be experience that prevails? Or will the yoke be on them? Well, at the moment, it's the youngster that's prevailing, but Haugen is still moving, and that's the key. Keep moving. Wow, look at that. Good time. And not bad for an old boy. Yeah, have something to celebrate as well. Two winners there.
For a last-minute replacement, Orca has put an incredible performance in.
Completely unexpected. What do we get now when Mark Felix tangles with Jani Virtanen? Two guys who came back from Madison Square Garden with a lot to prove. And Virtanen has made a slow start. Let's just put it that way. Felix is drifting off course, but we saw him do this before, and he came back to record a good time. Felix has got tremendous resolve. Once those legs get going, he's very good at keeping them going. Just did enough to get past the 20-metre line, 20.56. Virtanen has hit the wall. Well, Jani Virtanen is really battling with it, and once it hits the floor, that's it. And that's why this fella kept going. It didn't look pretty, but he completed. Now Kevin Nee against a fella who says he's getting too old for this game. But don't you be fooled, Jarek Dimek is still on top of his game. And let's face it, if Ode Haugen can still do it, these guys have got decades ahead of them. Both making steady progress, rhythm, momentum. Nee looking very good, Dimek slowing down just a little bit, but that's good. Yes, no wonder he's liking it. 14:31. And not bad at all from Dimmock. They'll both be well into the points with those scores. Yep, Dimmock started off matching knee neck and neck, but then it was knee, the younger man pulling away.
Kevin, much better start to this contest. Tell us about that.
Yeah, you know, I knew Yoke was a strong event for me. That's why I was disappointed I didn't get to do the Yoke last time at Madison Square, but I came out here, gave it my best, and right now I'm in the lead, but there's still two very good competitors left, so anything can happen.
After the break, we get our first look at the 22-year-old Norwegian sensation, Harald Haugen, who goes in the final pairing.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Another Christmas offer at Morrison's. These fresh jumbo king prawns are an incredible half price. The Christmas Price Crunch at Morrison's.
For the teamwork, for the training, for the challenge. Against enemies, against the elements, against the odds. For the travel, for the action, for adventure. With stealth, with precision, with pride. As a unit, as a team, through it all, together.
Hear from soldiers about life in the army at armyjobs.mod.uk.
Now your hair can be beautifully straight for twice as long. The new Babyliss Pro 230 Radiance uses Seraheat technology with four power heaters and combing fins for straightness proven to last twice as long as some other leading straighteners. Beautifully shiny, straight hair for longer. Babyliss Pro 230 Radiance.
Great value at PC World this Christmas, like this compact desktop PC with its 19-inch widescreen monitor, dual-core processor and a spacious 160-gig hard drive, now under £293. It's perfect for all the family. And when you buy Microsoft Office with Word, PowerPoint and Excel for under £98, get this printer absolutely free at PC World.
It's the 60s, and there are boys everywhere.
Britain was in the midst of a revolution.
It was free love. It was rejecting the old ideas.
It was turning the world upside down.
And it wasn't just sex that was being passed around. The 60s Revealed continues 9 o'clock Monday on 5.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Welcome back to Storefell in Norway. We're down to the final pairing in the first event, the Super Yoke. Over to Nick Halling to talk you through the action.
So the last pairing, Sebastian Venter going up against the local favourite, young Harald Haugen, who has threatened to take Norwegian strongman by storm. But it's Venter that is storming through this opening heat. Yeah, this is good from Venter. Kept the rhythm, kept the momentum, and he's 13 seconds dead. That should put him into the lead. And what about that? Was there too much pressure on Haugen, I wonder, in front of home fans?
Sebastian Venter shows us the form that got him on the podium at last year's finals with 13 seconds flat. Mark Felix can only manage seventh place. Now, this was a hard start to a contest organised by former World's Strongest Man, Sven Carlsen.
You know, it's fun for me now to see the two guys that I competed the most with, Janne Virtan and Magnus Samuelsson. They're still out there giving it a fight, but I think they lost some of the spirit we used to have back in the day. You know, they are very good on good days, but they're also very bad on bad days. We have two Norwegians here now, Rikard Skog and Arild Haugen. Unbelievable athletes, young guys with the fire in their heart. I'm on a crusade to take back strongman to Scandinavia. We have a lot of East European people now. Americans are getting good, and we definitely need some new blood from Scandinavia now.
So we're on to the deadlift. The next event is a pure test of strength, a gym test in many ways. The guys just have to grab the bar and stand up with as much weight as possible. Now, Madison Square Garden, Sven, we saw 395 kilos with three men, but all three failed at 4:05. What's the difference today? Can anyone break that barrier?
It will be broken because we're going to jump from 380 to 400, and the guys are allowed to use straps this time.
Straps, so their grip is tied onto the bar, so that won't be a factor.
Well, let's check out what's been happening in the early rounds of the deadlift. Well, for Cali Lane, 300, but a failure at 330. Maybe it's something to do with the sunglasses. Odd Haugen also checked out at 330. Something to do with the shorts. Jani Vertanen, he had a tough time, but he made 330. That was as far as it would go for him, though. Johannes failed also at 360, the youngster. Bastian Venter checked out at the same weight. So, a little bit more weight on that bar, 360, and in comes big Richard Skog. Second at Norway's strongest man from Trondheim. 30 seconds to do it. How much does he need? Well, not much at all. They enjoyed that in the cheap seats. They enjoyed it at the dinner tables as well. But nobody enjoyed it as much as Richard Skog. So up we go again. 380. Harald Haugen has got a lot of work to do after that disaster with the yoke. He doesn't need maximum points all the way, but he needs good points all the way. So no early checkouts needed here for Harald. And that looks good. And that looked like there was plenty more in it as well. And a look of almost disgust from the Norwegian as he put that bar down, as if to say, is that all you got? Mark Felix.
We saw Mark Felix in New York City at Madison Square Garden pulling 395 and failing 405 in disgust. Now he's got straps. He can't blame the bad grip, can he?
Eric Dimmock comes in with the shortest shorts in strongman. Whatever you feel comfortable in, huh? And what's Dimmock got? Ooh, a lot of effort. Has he got the lock? Yes, he has. Timed it perfectly. It's Kevin Nee up next, coming back from injury, but failed to crack the top six at Madison Square Garden, so this man is running out of chances.
I'm feeling pretty good, a little jet-lagged. It's like, you know, 4 a.m. for me right now, but otherwise feeling pretty good. At the deadlift at Madison Square Garden, I had it almost at lockout. My left arm, you know, it's coming back from the injury, it's still not 100%, and I just couldn't hold on to the weight. I wasn't strong enough, and every time I tried to inch it up a little bit more, it just falling out of my left hand, and eventually 390, I think it was 395? No, it was, 395 got the best of me. It fell out just at the last minute. Today shouldn't be an issue, though. We're allowed to use straps. And I'm using a deadlift suit, which I don't normally use. So I think that will add some weight. And with not having to worry about my hands, it should be, I really think, if my back's feeling good after this long traveling, I should hit 400, no problem.
Well, he says he's set a very high target for himself in this event. He certainly won't want to fail at 380. He feels there's a lot more to come. Returns to full fitness. And that was very easy. 380, brushed aside.
Incredible that a young man has such a top gym strength. Here we are at 400 kilos. This is world-class lifting now.
Harald has drawn some admirers. A lot of enthusiastic support for him. Can he break 400? The legs are wobbling, but the back is straightened, the tongue's out. And 400 it is. And they enjoyed that. But not as much as Harald. At one point you thought, no, it's not going to go, but as soon as you see the tongue, you know he's got it exactly. He's got it licked.
This will mean a lot to Mark if he gets it up.
Yeah, nicely controlled from Mark Felix, wasn't it?
Just, though. You remember his 395 at Madison was so much quicker.
York. Dimmock also trying to make 400. Oh, those thighs. Yarrick says, ha ha, I know when I'm beat. Didn't even waste any energy. So can he. Well, Kevin Nee was saying he wants 400 at least.
Well, this will be a personal best for him.
And this crowd really getting behind the young Bostonian. A little stumble, but he's kept it going. Has he got it? Is it locked in? He says yes. The judges say yes. And so the weight goes on. Another 10 kilos, five each side. So these guys are moving into uncharted territory now. Those that have made it this far, that is.
Kevin, 400 kilos, well done.
Thanks, man. Yeah, it's a real monkey off my back. I've been trying to hit 400 kilos on the deadlift for about a year now, and about time, man. About time. Feels good. So, and I'm pretty
410 now?
We'll see. We'll see, man. That last one was kind of rough, but we'll see.
Good luck.
Yep, 410. These fans really giving as much support as they possibly can.
Well, this would equal the strongman world record set by Gerrit Badenhorst in Mauritius in 1996. 410 kilograms.
It would be a huge lift. And they would raise the roof if Harald Haugen can get it, but that doesn't look very promising. He's going to give it a bit more. He only has 30 seconds, but no. Three times and out. And he knew it. Terrific deadlift, though, from Harald Haugen. Mark Felix claims to have the strongest back in the world, but he's been really busy lately, competing all over the place, and looked good at 400. How's he going to look at 410? Remember, in Madison Square Garden, he looked good at 395 and then failed at 405, and I think he might be failing at 410 here as he just readjusts the grip.
Well, I think he's just burnt out, Mark. 400 kilo, I mean, it's tremendous lifting. I can't imagine Kevin could do this. This would just be monumental after the biceps injury he's coming back from.
And having seen Haugen and Felix fail, it would be highly unlikely if Kevin Nee were to complete this one. But nevertheless, Nee to achieve a personal best of 400, absolutely fantastic. Surely there's not more in his tank. Oh, he's giving it a go! Oh, is he going to get this? He's close. He's very close. Has he got it? He's got it. Unbelievable from Kevin Nee. Totally unexpected. 400 was fantastic. 410 out of this world. Well, we saw it. I'm not sure any of us believe it, but you can believe it now. That second effort. And he's got it, 410. It's not sinking in yet. He's just got to hold it and hold it. Looking over at the judges, and yeah, you've got it. 410 for Kevin Nee.
Kevin, I think there's a little bit of surprise there. You thought that was 405 kilos, it's 410.
I thought it was 405, but that's even better news. I just can't believe it. I can't believe I finally hit 400, and I can't believe I beat Mark Felix. He's a far better deadlifter than me. I mean, I got lucky today, but any other day he'd beat me, but oh my God, I can't believe it.
If you didn't know that was 410, do you think you'd...
I don't think so. I think I'm lucky that I thought it was 405. I thought that's what we decided, so... Oh my God, I'm in the 900-pound club, man.
Kevin Nee. Well done, man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's brilliant weightlifting.
Yeah!
Kevin Nee, with a world record equaling lift of 410 kilos, takes maximum points. Harald Haugen and Mark Felix have to share second place in what was one of the most impressive strength contests ever. That puts Nee on top of the pile, with Poland's Sebastian Venter 5 points behind on 18. Mark Felix has managed to pull back some points on his best event, sitting on 16 and a half in fifth.
So the next event is the Viking press. You have to lift the end of this contraption up and press it overhead as many times as possible in 75 seconds. Now, Sven, the Viking, how heavy is this and who's your tip?
Wow, it's 145 kilo this time, Colin. And we're looking at Jarek Dymek or Sebastian Venter.
Well, let's take a look at the Viking lift. Odd Haugen managed 3 reps. And the shades didn't help Cali Lane one little bit. Jani Virtanen didn't do too badly, 6 reps for him. He won 45 kilos, but Richard Skog, who's in the top four, wants to stay there with 10. Now, the first of the two poles that Svend has tipped to do well in this. He's up against the young Swede, Arco. And Benta's flying already. And the Swede not doing too badly. It's not a race. What you want to do is conserve your energy here and more or less do your last lift, the last lift you're capable of in the last few seconds. Venta has absolutely torn this to shreds and looks like he could do another 14 as Archo Tech checks out. Well, Sven Carlsen knew something because he tipped Sebastian Venta, and Sebastian has responded with 16, exactly double the number of his rival. Now Mark Felix goes up against Jarek Dimmick here, probably still a little bit stunned that he lost a deadlift. Now, 16 is the magic number. By the time you get two poles together, you know there's a little bit of additional competition, and Dimmick is going off very fast here. You know what his number is, 17. That's what he's got in his mind. Felix is having a tough time again. Again, I think you're right, Colin. There's not much left in his tank at the moment because we've seen a lot more from him, and he needs to preserve it a little bit for the world's strongest man as Dimmick gets to 17 and says, that'll do, first place, thank you very much.
He looked good for two or three more, didn't he? That's Jarek's favourite event, and, well, he might be getting older, but he's still brilliant at any kind of shoulder event.
Older but wiser. This guy, well, running out of gas, isn't he? Just six. Yeah, he stopped at 17 because he knew that was enough. And did you see when he walked away a little wink of the eye? Harald Haugen's girlfriend watching closely. As our man try and get 17. And Kevin Nee, well, is there more heroics here from the Red Sox fan? Or did that deadlift take a lot out of him? Yeah, you can hear Harold's girlfriend. He's going okay so far, but those two poles are way out there, 16 and 17, remember. And Haugen needs to kind of get into that company to keep the pressure on. He's in touch with the top four, Haugen. But he needs more than nine. And he's stuck at 11. I don't think Harold's in trouble. He's in trouble. Is he allowed to get a bit of coaching on the from the sidelines, I wonder? No, it's not going to get him a lift, is it? Just nine. That's not enough. Ooh, disappointing. And Kevin Nee says 13. Well, that's going to have to be lucky for me.
Jarek, victory. Another great event for you, though, yeah?
Yeah, but the winning was not important with the other guys. I only want to win the Viking press with this big gorilla, Sebastian Venta.
Now, Sebastian, your English is improving. Tell us, a good day for you.
I like the Viking press. I have strong shoulders. Sebastian Venta will be champion today.
Honestly, he's not really good.
Bit of DIY auto cue there as veteran Jarek Dimmick takes his first event win with 17 reps ahead of his compatriot Sebastian Venta. But the pressure is on Mark Felix. He managed to get a seventh equal with Jani Virtanen, but to make the cut after the next event, he has to be in the top six. With no problems though, and out on top is the American Kevin Nee with 33. After the break, it's the heaviest tire flip ever attempted, an event where Mark Felix can blow hot and cold.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Everybody loves DVD magic. The best of Jethro.
I don't want to be too late tonight because my wife lost her voice and I don't want to miss it.
15 years of laughter.
I went in a fish and chip shop with a salmon under my arm. I said, you sell fish cakes? He said, no. I said, pity, because it's his birthday today.
A giant portion of Jethro, his best on DVD now.
ABBA, the original singing game, brings the legends of pop to PlayStation. Put on your platforms, grab the mic, and get your ABBA party started. Inside everyone, there's a SingStar. SingStar ABBA, only on PlayStation.
Sleigh bells ring.
Sleigh bells ring.
Are you listening?
Snow is glistening, a beautiful sight. We're happy tonight, walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we can build a snowman,
snowman,
then pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no man,
no man.
But you can do the job when you're in town. Plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland, walking in a winter wonderland.
Now you can ask us anything.
Can't think of anything to ask? Text joke to 118118 and we'll send you a joke.
Got your answer.
Be seduced.
Two and two sexy men.
Two and two sexy men.
Carolina Herrera, New York.
Get animated with the best in box set animation at great prices. Family Guy.
Grandpa! Somebody call an ambulance!
Lois, maybe you better call two ambulances.
Futurama.
Everybody do the bending.
American Dad.
Get that away from me! Die, calories, die!
King of the Hill. And The Simpsons.
My all-purpose electric hammer. For all your pounding need.
Get animated now.
For a free mobile phone film showing what the Army can offer you, text FILM to 61110 now.
One Army, regular and territorial.
Christmas, we are all Guitar Heroes. Guitar Hero World Tour. Get on the bus. Out now on Xbox 360. Console from $129.99.
It's Christmas. You don't want to do things by halves. No, that's our job. Half price sale now on at Tesco. Every little helps.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Welcome back to the World's Strongest Man Super Series in Norway. The next event is a strongman favourite, but this time it's heavier than ever. A tyre has to be flipped six times in 75 seconds. Fastest time will win if anyone can finish it.
Well, Callie Lane has dispensed with the sunglasses and still only gets three flips. He'll be watching from the stands along with Odd Haugen, who managed just two flips. That tyre is hurtful. Mark Felix, one flip. He will not make the top six, and there is a cut at the end of this. Mark will be on the wrong end of it. Jani Virtanen has had a big push, though. 68 seconds. Orka against Haugen next, and Haugen's been a little bit under the weather in the build-up to this competition.
I know my strongest man, it went great for me. I won the 4 of 6 event, and I did a great show on the Apollon's axle. Two repetitions for 265 kilo easily, and also the 180 kilo stone that nobody lifted here last year went straight up. So this is a competition I'm looking forward to. It's a big international competition in my home ground, and this is my town, my country. Sven Carlsen is one of the greatest strongmen ever lived, and he's from Norway, and he has done a lot for us kids to coming out in the world and competing international. And he is also a very great guy in many ways, and teaching us and arranging competition like this in the Norwegian Championship. So it means a lot to us. The favorite today will of course be myself, if not wouldn't I be here. But I guess Kevin E is a quite strong, good competitor. Sebastian Venta, Jarek Dimek, I think those three will be absolutely in the top. The events are very good for them, like pressing and deadlift, but it will be a hard competition. Yeah, I'm grown up in Stavanger in Norway. That's where the Vikings originally came from. So there's like a lot of Viking farms and all that stuff in my home country. So I'm used to picking up stones in the fields. So I think it's like a natural born to me doing strongman and lifting stones and heavy stuff. So this is like natural for me, and I'm ready to fight the best in the world today. And I'm also gonna show the other guys that stones are one of my best events. So I will pick up the 5 stones like nothing. If you have the Viking spirit in your blood like me, no one can beat you at Viking country in Norway.
So the young Swede nearest us, the young Norwegian to the far side, and they know 68 seconds is the time to beat. That's if they can do 6 flips. Ooh, it looks hard for the Swede, doesn't it? But Haugen, look at this. He knows as well that if there's a top four finish here, that guarantees automatic qualification for the world's strongest man. That would be some achievement as well.
Well, I think both of these men are gunning for top four. Haugen, despite that terrible start in the Super Yoke, he's coming back. Each event getting stronger and stronger.
Maximum points for Harald Haugen. And how much can the Orca do? You see Haugen jumping in there and saying, come on, give it a go. And the Swede trying to get some momentum from any source. Now, is there another flip here? No, there isn't, I don't think. But that's not bad. Not bad at all.
Well, have we found a new Swedish star after Magnus Samuelsson seems to just be past his best?
He wants to have another look at it, doesn't he? But I think a part of him is thinking, you know what? I want that 75 seconds just to come up. Oh, this is really... That's phenomenal if he does this. Come on, you can do it. Oh, that's unlucky. Oh, that's a shame. 5 flips, but not bad. Richard Skog currently in 4th place. Kevin Nee. So Skog looking to try and keep in the top four, because that means he'll be going to the Worlds, and that's not a good sign. Kevin Nee's, oh, this is a very bad sign for Kevin Nee as well. Remember, Kevin has done an awful lot of work in this tournament, and don't forget he's coming off that injured bicep as well, although there was no sign of a bicep problem in the deadlift, so you can't suddenly use it as an excuse, and I'm sure he wouldn't. But these guys aren't exactly flying, are they?
You just wonder how much Kevin spent on that 400 kilos, then the 410 kilo deadlift world record. Skog looks so strong, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's going to be okay for a top six, and I think this should maintain him in the top four. But Kevin, well, it's lucky that he's got plenty of breathing room at the head of affairs.
Such a big man, Skog. 24, 25 stone, 6'5". And it's good when you can lean your body weight in against the tyre. You can use it as leverage against it.
Nicely done. And he just takes second place as well there. Kevin might as well hoist the white flag on this one, because I don't think that tyre is going anywhere. Sometimes you just have to say the event beats you. But he'll hate that. One flip. He's so competitive. Sebastian Venter with those long arms of his going up against Jarek Dimek in the all-Polish battle. Interesting to see if Venter can use that wingspan to his advantage here. Let's hope his tyre flipping is better than his English. Such a lovely fellow, though. Really is one of the nice guys. It's just that you have to speak Polish to know what he's talking about. Dimek here. That was very weary, wasn't it? The two of them really starting to struggle. It's been a long old competition, and the stones are still in front of them as well.
Well, Sebastian just can't find a grip at all. He's going wide, he's going narrow. He can't figure this tyre out at all.
Just close to encroaching into his opponent's lane here. Dimek having a good long look. Is he going to get another turn? Keep that momentum, got to keep it moving. I think he's got it. Yes, he has. I'm not sure Venter's got it, though.
It's getting it past that sticking point, isn't it? Mm. You get it halfway, and do you kick it with one leg, and then you go onto one leg, or do you try and use your arms? It's very difficult.
And the worst of it is you have to put so much into it that when you've done a flip, you get this tremendous sense of achievement, and psychologically, you want to stop, and your body shuts down. Yeah, 3 for Venter, whose English is good enough to say thank you. But 4 for Dimek. So 3 men complete the course. Absolutely sensational, wasn't he? Really was.
So, Harold, this was a good event for you, but you look tired.
Yeah, that's true. I'm a little bit tired after some sickness last 2 days, but I'm always a power machine, so I will do the last two events. And the stone, I will win the stones.
Good man. Well done.
Thank you.
Three men completed the six flips, with Harold Haugen coming out on top with a time over twice as fast as the others. Mark Felix's one flip, though, means his contest is over.
Mark, you must be very disappointed with today, am I right?
Oh, yeah, I'm very disappointed with today. Since Britain's Strongest Man, I keep doing shows every week. You know, I'm so tired. You know, I just want a big break now. I'm so tired. I'm drained. I'm mentally and physically drained now. I just need a break.
After four events, Richard Skoog is equal first with Jarek Dimek. Mark Felix misses the cut behind Johannes Ocher, who's turned out to be a real surprise.
So our next event is the Apollon's Axel, last man standing again, starting 140 kilos, just over 300 pounds. Now, doing a personal best in the last man standing deadlift was our competition leader, along with Jarek Dimek, Richard Skoog. Congratulations, Richard, and is this a kind of event that suits you too?
Thank you, Colin. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the Axel because it's a good event for me. My best is 170 kilos, but now I'm very tired, many events, so you won't see that now, but I will do my best, promised.
I think this is a war of attrition. Really is last man standing here in Norway.
Well, who's going to be the big dog out of this pack? This keeps getting heavier and heavier, doesn't it? Kevin Nee at 180.
Oh, that's 400 pounds in old money. That's a difficult enough clean and jerk if you're on an Olympic lifting bar, but the thickness of that handle.
It's a big part of the problem, isn't it? Just getting grip and control on that handle. Venter. Can't quite turn the wrist there, can he? Time, not yet an issue, but he's got to be able to flip those wrists, and he's struggling again. And is he going to make it? Yes, he did. Now he's got a chance. Yeah, got the elevation as well. That was a terrific regroup from Venter. It looked like he was done and dusted there. I don't think he's going to get any higher, though. Look at the exertion. Dimek at 180.
Imagine if he gets it to his shoulders, he'll press it.
Oh, no, Dimek says that's that. Dimek's been around the block long enough to know when he's been beaten. Couldn't get the lift, couldn't get the flick of the wrists, and said thank you. Young Johannes at 180. The future, they say, of Swedish strongman is the future now. Well, that looks okay, but can he finish the job here? Can he get the elevation? Straighten up those legs, get the arms locked, nicely done. That was Swedish for yes, I did it. That's the edited version anyway. Why not? Something to shout about here. He's still on course for a top four finish, you know, which would see him into the world's strongest man qualification. Richard Skoog would just like to win this event outright. He's got a chance. He says he's getting tired. Is that a bit of kidology? Listen to this crowd. They love it. The arms, they're locked. He's got it. And somebody has got a souvenir.
Well, they're all right on the limit here, aren't they, Nick? No one's really making this look easy. Be interesting what weight they go up to after this, and whether Harold Haugen, of course, will join them.
Well, Haugen needs to join them. He's thinking top four, and it's so congested at the top of the leaderboard. This Super Series is still up for grabs. And Haugen, he was wobbling. Have they given it to him? Well, he was leaning like a tower in Italy, but they let him off. He did get the elbows locked in. That was close, though. Harold Haugen was absolutely at his limit. There is not another lift there.
Well, I like it when the lifters look at the judges with those eyes. I've got it, I've got it. When they know full well they really haven't got it. A bit of kidology with the judges. 185, Nick.
Nobody looked good at 180. And Kevin, I do hope that's not a recurrence of his bicep problem. It looks like it could be. And the way he reacted was like something snapped, fingers crossed. So, well, Kevin Nee gets some attention. Sebastian, who couldn't get the wrist flipped last time, well, he's got it there, no. Everything went into the wrist, and it is really starting to hurt those joints now. Sebastian literally bows out, and he doesn't look in good shape. I hope he hasn't hurt himself. Haugen only just made the 180. It would be a big shock if he gets 185, but there is the incentive. Bonus points. Because Nee has gone. Has he got it? Listen to this crowd. Did he get it? I don't think he got the control. It was close. It was mighty close.
Well, that was a good decision for the referees. He wasn't under control. I don't think he's going to do it now.
But so close. How frustrating for Harold Haugen. He was within a couple of the tenths of a second.
Well, look, Richard Skog's pulled out. He's not even going for this weight, so this is our last man.
The youngster. Now, we're all rooting for him. Last man standing. Can he get 185? He's got the flick. The wrists are turned. All he needs is the elevation. Lock those elbows. No, they're going to have to share top spot, a whole bunch of them, at 180. And Kevin Nee in some trouble. Yeah, that's not looking too good for the popular young American, is it?
It's a five-way tie for the win on the Apollon's axle, only Jarek Dimek failing to get the 180 kilograms up. Overall, then, the leaderboard has never been tighter. Richard Skog leads by half a point ahead of Nee, but any one of the top six can finish on the podium. Though Kevin Nee's glorious return from injury looks in doubt.
Kevin, that looks like a very painful injury. What's happened there?
I felt a little bit of a muscle pull. I think it was maybe some nerve damage still from the surgery. And, you know, I had a great competition so far, but I'll let the Norwegians battle it out on their soil. It was a great contest, and definitely happy to be here. Hopefully I'm invited again next year. And, I'm happy I got the 410 pull, so that will hold me over. But, hopefully this thing, heals up. Just be safe than sorry, and hopefully I just get the invite to Worlds, so we'll see what happens.
Very sensible. Well done.
Thanks. Thank you.
Unbelievable is a word often overused in sports shows, but this has been an unbelievable sporting contest, Sven, and we're down to the stones to finish off. Who can put on this big 180-kilo stone? Who will take the title?
Well, I tell you a little inside story, Colin. We used this for Norway's Strongest Man, and Arild Haugen lifted this last stone like it was paper. He's my favorite to win the whole Viking Power Challenge this year.
But any of the guys could come out on top here. The points are so close.
Well, Jarek Dimek is just three stones. And not quite bringing his A game to Norway, the ever popular veteran pole. What can Johannes manage? Easy enough. But remember, the columns go down in height, but those stones increase drastically in weight. Yeah, you need more than one guy behind them. Yeah, can he match Dimek? Yes, he can.
This has been a series of personal bests for this man, this young man. Phenomenal, really. Up goes number four.
There really is a changing of the guard, isn't there, in strongman? You've got a couple of young Americans making huge waves. Now we're getting the likes of Harold Haugen and Johannes Orca involved.
And remember, Nick, the only man to ever have lifted this stone is Harold Haugen. Not even Pudzianowski's done this final one.
He's asking how much time he's got. Time is not the issue. But any time you see somebody wandering around like this, you is a guy that's looking for somewhere to hide, I think. I'm not sure he wants this. He wants to give it a go, but I'm not sure he believes that he can do it. Now, can he prove everybody wrong? Everyone's willing it to happen, but it's not going to happen, and I think he knew it before he even attempted it. But what a tremendous effort. Four at a good time.
Four men to go, and this Grand Prix is still wide open. Join us after the break.
sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Between love and madness lies obsession. Love. Madness. It's my secret. Secret obsession. The new fragrance from Calvin Klein.
Calvin Klein Man, the new fragrance.
I thought I could trust you. You said you weren't motivated by revenge. I think you're so blinded by inconsolable rage that you don't care who you hurt.
I'm motivated by my duty.
Quantum of Solace, the game. Out now on Xbox 360. Console from $129.99.
He came to warn us. They came to destroy us. Now, we fight back. The day the earth stood still.
Is it Brokeback Mountain?
New one.
The Great
Thing?
Escape to the festive menu at McDonald's, including the big cheese and bacon, the chicken fiesta, and the festive pie.
Is it Free Willy?
Can anyone work an extra shift tonight?
I'll just have to check.
Mum says OK.
There's an easier way to make a call when your mobile phone is out of credit. Just dial 0800-REVERSE.
I find myself in an exhilarating journey. The scent of adventure in the air. Leading me further and further into the realms of the extraordinary. Every smell, every sight, every step push me forwards. Until I found myself in a place where I saw something magnificent. I saw my life in a whole new light. Davidoff Adventure, the new fragrance for men.
A great new offer every day for the 12 days of Christmas. Go online now to find out today's festive offer from littlewoodsdirect.com.
Get 10% off all fragrance gift sets until Wednesday at Boots.
For the teamwork, for the training, for the challenge. Against enemies, against the elements, against the odds. For the travel, for the action, for adventure. With stealth, with precision, with pride. As a unit, as a team. Through it all together.
Hear from soldiers about life in the army at armyjobs.mod.uk.
Flawless, radiant, and visibly even skin. Now on your underarms. Rich in face care ingredients like omega 6, hydrating glycerol, and 1/4 moisturizing cream. Dove deodorant is the beauty treatment for your underarms. Dove deodorant.
Classic story of boy...
I'm Lucy.
...meets girl.
I'm Henry Rush.
Boy meets girl.
What's your name?
I'm Henry.
Again and again and again and again. 51st Dates, tomorrow at 8 on 5.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.
Welcome back to Norway, and the final four are about to go. This is still anyone's to win.
So Sebastian Vento, and we're hearing that Kevin Nee has had to withdraw. That's terrible news for Kevin with that injury. And depending on what happens here, it's so tight at the top, he could get pushed right out of the top four altogether, which means he would not automatically qualify for the world's strongest man. Vento is tearing it up. Three done in very fast time. This fourth to knock his compatriot off top spot. He's done that. So Venter gets four, so he's guaranteed, and in a very good time as well, so he's guaranteed good points. We're kind of assuming nobody's going to get this fifth stone, and Sebastian certainly isn't, but 24.5, that's good, that's fast. That might be good enough to take this title. But still two to come. And here's the first of them, Harold Haugen. What a popular victory this would be. You can see, Harold's still got his cheerleaders here, getting as close to the action as they possibly can. And Harold's got to keep one eye on the clock as well. Remember, Venter's time, 24.5 for four stones.
He is manhandling these stones. One movement up to the platforms.
Well, this is the fourth stone. Keep an eye on the clock. He's ripped it to pieces. So he's inside Venter's time, and he's still on course for top spot here. Surely he's not going to get the fifth. He is. Oh, who needs to bother with the time? If you get five stones, you make the clock irrelevant.
And Nick, he didn't even stop halfway and readjust his hands. Did you see the way he lifted that fifth stone? I've never seen anyone lift a 180-kilo stone like that before. And you only see a 180-kilo stone lifted very, very occasionally.
Look at this. And not only was it a fifth stone, 26 seconds dead. Well, he's earned a drink, hasn't he? Make it a double, Harold. Well, follow that. Richard Skog. So, five stones now needed. We've assumed all along it's only going to be four. Keep an eye on Venter's time for four, 24.5. He's blasted his way through the first two. Adrenaline really kicking in here. A little stumble on ball three there. That stone seemed to just catch the wrist as it went through. And I think Venter's 24.5 is going to be OK. It's more than OK. Skog might not even get this fourth stone. Well, three will be a major disappointment for the man that went into the Atlas Stones leading. He's not going to get five, though. He's hurt. Everything went into that.
I think he's just cramped there. But he's brave, isn't he? He's fighting on here. He's had a tremendous competition. Another man with a series of personal bests in just about everything.
And look at this. Harold Haugen willing his compatriot to get this fifth stone. I don't think it's going to happen. Goodness knows how Haugen got it. Haugen's telling him, you can do this. Come on, Richard, you can do this. Last chance, and that chance is gone. He has to settle for four in 33.57, so he doesn't beat Venter. Stone me, this is the result for the Atlas Stones. Harold Haugen takes top spot ahead of Sebastian Venter and Johannes Orca in third. And in the big picture, it's Haugen who started slow but who blasted his way through to win on home soil. He'll be joined in the world's strongest man by Venter, Skog, and the very impressive young Johannes Orca.
So that's it here in Norway, and a Viking wins. Sven, you must be very proud of Harold.
I'm very proud to leave the throne now over to this young man. We're sure going to have a lot of fun in the future now with a new Norwegian on the crusade to bring home what's rightfully Norwegian, the crown of world's strongest man.
Hand over the helmet, my friend. Well done, Harold. It must feel good.
Yeah, this is the greatest ever happened to me. My first international victory in a bad day. It feels fantastic. And watch out, world, I'm coming.
Well, the torch has been passed, hasn't it? And the helmet goes on to the head of Harold Haugen, the next in a long line of Norwegian strongmen.
Well, the mountains of his homeland seem to have inspired the young Norwegian Harold Haugen to victory. He must now be viewed as one of the favourites for the Strongest Man finals to be held here in West Virginia later on in the year. And remember, at the age of 22, if he was to win, he'd be the youngest ever champion. At the other end of the scale, Jerek Dimek still proving he has what it takes to get through to the big time. There is, of course, one more qualifying Super Series event. That's going to take place on the west coast of Sweden, Magnus Samuelsson territory. Can the former world champion get through to his 13th final? We shall have to wait and see. Until then, goodbye.
Thanks, Martin. Yep, and you only have to wait till next Friday at 8 p.m. to see that last qualifier in Sweden. Next, we'll get you feeling all festive with Nigel Marvin's Polar Bear Adventure.
Sponsored by Fisherman's Friend.